This is Josiah Plays Torment, Tides of Numenera. Alright, we're going to ask Pelii a few more questions, even though I really hate doing her voice, because it's really obnoxious. Alright.
I hope you'll have news for me.
How can I reach the sticker layer?
Making a note.
If I knew, I would go there myself. The sticker are quick to dispatch intruders, and I doubt they would take humans or vigilance out of the role of the court. Perhaps a construct of some sort or a digging machine. But I know little of fabrication or manufacturing, so I will leave that for you to explore.
I'm still looking for a way into the Stitcher there, just since the last time I asked you. Any other ideas?
Some sort of digging construct, perhaps?
She leans close.
This is your puzzle, my friend. I am merely your employer.
Can you tell me about yourself? Hey, Expecto, how you doing? No, this voice acting is terrible. It's terrible, I know, I'm sorry. But I gotta do it. The thing is, when I play these games that have all this text, I feel like I must read the text aloud, because when I watch other people stream these kind of games and they don't read the text, it annoys me, and I think, oh, I wish they'd read the text. So then I have to do it. And if I'm reading the text and it's all these different characters, I feel like I can't just read them all in the same voice, because that's like not immersive or whatever. So I have to try to voice act the characters, even though I'm not very good at it. Can you tell me about yourself? She warbles deep in her throat.
I am Pelii, an accredited agent of the slave families. I act with their full faith and authority to resolve the Stitcher crisis.
And I'm trying to do a really weird voice for this character because she's like a fish person. Like a fish person. Can you tell me about yourself again? I love asking the questions twice.
I am Pelii. I am in the employ of the slave families who govern the city.
You mentioned the slave families. Who are they? She scoffs and then points to the sigil marked upon her breast.
The slave families are the descendants of those brave swords who rose against the injustice of the previous rulers of Sega's cliffs. Led by Chilla the Great, they cast down the tyrants and tore their families asunder. The faithful who stood with Chilla saw their service rewarded with stewardship of the city. Their descendants carry on with this grand tradition.
Oh, they're the descendants of slaves. Okay, that's a lot better than what I was thinking. I thought these fuckers were just, like, families that had a lot of slaves, and they were really proud of it. We're the slave families! You know how many slaves we have? But no, okay, they're the descendants of slaves. Alright, we cool then. We cool. Can you tell me about the slave families again?
They are the leaders of the city, the shepherds of the poor and downtrodden. It is through their beneficence that we continue to survive against those who will exploit us.
She waves a hand to indicate the surrounding cavern.
They have made their agent. They have made me their agent, so that I can carry their word even to the darker recesses of the city.
So in other words, they picked you to be the ambassador to the shitty, stinky underground caverns full of weird creatures because you're a Vargellan. I'm sensing some racism here. They're like, all right, we're going to make some ambassadors to the different parts of the city. You there, John, you can be the ambassador to Awesome Town. And you, Bill, you can be the ambassador to Shiny Town. And you, Mary, you can be the ambassador to Clean Town. And you, nasty fish creature, you will be our ambassador to Shithole. I'm just saying. I'm just saying. I'm looking for a pale woman named Matkina.
The name is familiar, and all pale humans are rare. One would imagine I might recall someone of that description. Alas, I do not.
Oh, perception's kicking in here. Her crest deflates and reinflates slightly as she says this, and it reminds you somehow of evasion, deception. Oh, something's fishy about what she's telling me. Come on, something's fishy. Come on, you gotta give me some love for that one. When I make a really stupid joke, I get all proud of myself for it for some reason. You are familiar with Matkina, aren't you? I just called her out. She holds up her hands.
Only by her reputation. It may be that she found employment with the council at one time. I know no more.
What can you tell me about the Stitcher?
Filled the animals, scuttered the insects. Who can s-
Alright, hold on. You're a fucking fish thing. And you're gonna get mad at them for being insect things? Come on now.
Who can say if they're even sentient? First and foremost, they dig. And they care nothing for the homes they destabilize or the lives that are lost when our buildings collapse. They do not speak the truth reliably, so we cannot know if they understand the damage they cause.
She frowns.
Though I suspect that they do.
I like the fact that their language, the common tongue in this setting, is called the truth. That's a cool name for a language. A little bit propaganda-y, but hey.
Ask me your questions. Perhaps we shall find a way to deal with these monsters.
Where did the sticker come from? Her eyes wobble in frustration.
If I knew, I would send them back there in a trice. Some years ago, perhaps decades, they simply appeared here, and they have been causing problems ever since.
Can you tell me where the sticker came from again?
Anything else I convey, it's rumor and speculation, but I have told you as what I know.
What are the sticker doing here?
I cannot imagine. They dig incessantly. They insist upon digging tunnels underneath the city, destabilizing the crag upon which Stegos Cliffs is built. Countless buildings have collapsed or fallen into the sea, more so than is ordinary based on the shoddy construction so many of our residents employ. The problem has struck Cliff's Edge especially. Many loyal citizens have perished.
But can you tell me what the Stitcher are doing here again?
They dig and dig and dig more. What they want is a mystery. They do not respond to us. They do not speak. They simply dig.
It's amazing that they haven't started wiping these guys out yet, honestly. How do you communicate with them? Her crest flutters as she hisses in irritation.
I have not the faintest idea. I do not even know if they fully understand the truth. Perhaps the one that points at itself and chitters can help. I call it Chket. It can mutter a handful of words and perform some sign language. I have tried to negotiate with it, but I have gotten nowhere.
Can you tell me how you communicate them with them again?
You're the large one that I call Chiquette. I hope you have patience for its charades.
I had other questions.
Ask.
No, I guess I don't. Farewell.
Indeed.
Alright, good. I'm glad to be done talking to her because that voice was obnoxious. Let's go talk to Chiquette. Chiquette. Hold on, there's loot up here. Let's get the loot first. Somebody left some shins behind. This tunnel is blocked by debris, but it's loose enough that a burrowing creature could easily push its way through. Oh, really? Some juvenile stickuses. Are these guys going to attack me if I just randomly wander up in here? It says the same thing as the last tunnel. At least she didn't call you child. Yeah, that's true. Says the same thing. Here's some stuff I can loot. Some more shins. Can I talk to these juvenile stick eye? Click. Shick. Alright. Alright, Chiquette, are you ready for this? This massive creature looms over you. A scent like lightning in an underground cavern washes over you and reminds you of nothing so much as curiosity. It chitters and rumbles, waving its large claws through an expressive dance. Something about these smells, sounds, and gestures seems familiar, a niggling itch in the back of your mind. At least you remember the taxonomy now. This is a stickus, a huge burrowing insectoid. It points to itself and says, "Chicken." It follows with another stream of high-pitched noise. Can you tell me about the sticker? It scrabbles briefly at the wall, and a bit of lightning flares about the crown of antennae on its head. Its shoulders shrug, and you smell dust. Can you tell me more about the sticker? It chitters and grumbles. Its chitters and grumbles remain incomprehensible to you. It nods its head at you, and when you fail to respond, it trills,
"Duck, other question!"
What do you think of Pelii? The sticker seems discombobulated for a moment.
Oh.
Then it thinks a little more. Then it sprays out a blast of pheromones, and you smell the sharp tang of acid and weakened stone. It smells like distrust. Ah, yes, the telltale smell of distrust. Can we talk about Pelii again? The stickus huffs out a barely visible cloud of moisture, and its faint odor is that of faulty eggs rotting under buried radiation. It seems that Chekect doesn't trust Pelii at all. Well, I don't either. I wouldn't trust her, considering she just hired me to go into your tunnels and steal all your eggs so that they can use them as a lever against you. So many strange creatures in this game, I love their different personalities. Yeah, exactly. Pheromone wars. What can you tell me about this place? I love how I'm just talking to the thing as though we can communicate normally. It looks at you intently, and then its spatulate fingers begin a slow and careful dance. The sounds it makes are slow chitters that rise and fall in pitch, accompanied by the smell of ozone.
Good rock, full of electricity!
You almost have the sense of the language, the structure, the feel, the sound and scent. The itch in your mind intensifies. You can feel the memory of the stickus language waiting to reveal itself. Ah, I can learn. I can get one of the changing gods' memories and learn how to communicate with them. Let's try to remember how to speak the stickus language. Tutorial, Edge. You or a companion now have Edge in one of your stat pools. I'm an Edgelord. Granting you a discount on using points from that stat pool. Each level of Edge grants one free level of effort, boosting your minimum chance of success. When using an ability, Edge reduces the activation cost first, and any leftover points are used for effort. Great. So I can use this first level of effort for free. Because I have 1 point of intellect edge. Anamnesis, the remembering of things from a supposed previous existence. Yeah. There you have it. This is not going to be easy, though. And look, none of my companions can help with this. I have to do it myself, because obviously they're not going to remember things from the Changing God. Well, let's go ahead and spend a point. Otherwise, it's only a 40% chance. Success! Gain 3 XP. Your mind blurs, a memory racing up from forgotten depths. You see yourself interacting with a stickus, the two of you patiently exchanging hand signals, a small box between the two of you translating your words and thoughts. Each time it conveys a thought or concept, the device sends a stimulus into the appropriate parts of your brain, and electricity into your limbs, making you a marionette. Your muscles twitch in sympathy with these... in sympathy with these memories, and you realize that the stickus tongue is a jumble of scent, movement, and sounds. With the memory, information pours into your mind as if a plug had been removed. The smell of granite fills your nose. Yeah, this conversation would be very difficult if you failed to remember. As you return to normal consciousness, Chiquette leans forward.
Chiquette, smell granite! Knowledge!
It rumbles. Its spiracles vent a minuscule trace of gas. The stickist looks at you, and its body posture and slight movements indicate a question.
Does human speak, stickus?
Your muscles remember, and you twitch the proper response. Twitch. Chiquette huffs the scent of lightning.
Never speak Chiquette to human, so heard memory from elder, not believe. Human almost sentient. Imagine. Grub think like stickus.
It claps its hands together.
Smeak spark. Better now.
The stickus just passed some gas. Yeah, half their communication is all based on stinky farts. Now, can you tell me more about the sticker? It considers the question briefly and then emits a puff of pheromones that smells of soft rock, crumbling under determined hands. It reminds you of resigned acceptance.
Speak. Chiquette will answer.
Why are you digging here?
This arm.
Chiquette raises its great arm.
Dig. Draw energy from rock, from friction. Eat electric charge. Store electric charge.
It points to the spiky growths on its plating.
Here, rock good. Hard, much electric. Best found. Other places, not good.
So they're collecting electricity by digging. Very interesting. Sven Sinclair, how you doing? You like the name Chiquette? Why, it's good you have no children. They would end up with horrible names. Oh, man. If you had a kid and named it Chiquette, that'd be bad news. That kid would not be happy. Hey, Kilobyte. Good to see you. How you doing, Kilobyte? Can you tell me why you dig here again? Oh, he actually said the exact same thing. Normally, when you ask somebody a question the second time, they always say something different. Why are you digging under populated areas? The sticker stares blankly at you, its eyes shimmering. It seems to be trying to put its thoughts into a statement you can understand.
Sticker must survive! Must live where food is, yes!
It doesn't wait for an affirmation.
Human, watch every step! Avoid stepping on insects! No impact on other life! Sacrifice of others is natural order!
Okay. They're just trying to eat. He's got a point. We don't exactly worry about what happens to insects when we're doing our thing. In fact, I go out of my way to kill them sometimes. Well, mostly spiders. I don't really kill most insects. Spiders and centipedes. I don't just kill them like if I randomly see them in nature. That's their spot. Do your thing in nature. But if you're in my fucking apartment, you're not invited. You are trespassing at that point. And I have the right to kill you. So, if spiders and centipedes want to fuck around in my apartment, they die. That's all there is to it. I'm doing pretty good. Thanks, Kilobyte. Enjoying this game. It taps you in the chest.
Smart for human.
Points toward the rest of the underbelly.
Not smart. Why concern? Not.
It gropes for the word.
Not sentient.
Okay, so they consider us humans to be unintelligent, non-sentient creatures. They consider us like we would consider animals. So they're not worried about killing some of us accidentally. Eric the Dead, how you doing? You killed a mouse for eating your mom's couch once? A mouse ate your mom's couch? That mouse must have been fucking full. Wow. That is like one of those championship eaters, you know? That mouse can eat. Maybe it was a very small couch. You claimed the people in the city aren't sentient. That's not true. The sticker shifts its weight back and forth.
Simple humans! Fight! Eat! Kill! Try steal eggs! Not harmony! Sentient!
It trills out a scoff. Yeah, he's got a point. Oh, it didn't eat the whole thing. Okay. Man, I thought that was a really fucking cool story if it ate the whole couch. Like, dude, that mouse is a champion. We need to study that motherfucker if it ate a whole couch. Okay, it just ruined it. That makes more sense. How's it going, Blinking Ninja? Alright. Your digging is causing problems for the people above.
Not concerned to Stitcher!
How did you come to be under Sega's cliffs? It shrugs, its massive exoskeletal plates grinding.
No ancient ever to tell! 4 generations only in caves! We live instinct, only guess at legacy. Memory stolen!
Growls in frustration. It pats the wall nearby.
Stickers hatch from egg! Yes, yes! Traders come from evil bloom! Other worlds!
This is interesting. They got an interesting story going on here. Memories stolen. I wonder if the changing god is behind that. Kind of like that guy that ate a whole car. What, Kilobyte? Okay, I need to hear this story. A guy ate a whole car. What are you even talking about?
Think humans stole eggs. Humans brought eggs to world. Humans hatch eggs. Larval stickers. A mystery to buyer. Released here.
Ah, so they're from another world. Chiquette exhales from its spiracles.
Must guess at function. Must guess at society. Maybe advanced once. Maybe great civilization. Now only dig. Dig for clues.
Mr. Scotty Mac, how you doing? How long have I put into this game so far? I'm gonna say 10 hours. I'm gonna say 10 hours. There's a guy who ate a car. It took him a really long time. I think he ground it up and added it to his food or something. That's amazing. That is amazing. Wow. Now I have a new ambition in life. I'm going to eat a boat. A whole boat. Fuck a car. Cars are for noobs. I'm eating a boat. A big boat. Now, step one. Acquire a boat. I need to put up one of those donation goal things on my stream. You know how people have those where they want to get a certain thing, like a new PC or a video card or whatever, and they put a donation goal up? I need to put up a donation goal for boat to eat. how much am I going to have to pay to get a nice edible boat? That fiberglass, though. Yeah. Yeah. Well, I'm not saying it'll be good for me. You were on the fence about this or Mass Effect Andromeda as the game to play and stream from beginning to end. I would say, unless you really love reading, go with Mass Effect Andromeda. GoFundMe. Fire Snake Ares wants to eat a large boat. You know, the funny thing is, people are weird on the internet. If that got enough hype or enough press to where people knew it existed, I think people would fund that. I think the internet would rise up to fund a person eating a boat. I think they would. I mean, that's the kind of shit that gets done on the internet because the internet is so strange. All right, let's keep going with this conversation here. They dig for clues. Can you tell me how you came to be under Sega's cliffs again?
Do not remember. Eggs of forebears stolen to here. Never saw homeworld. Never saw natural skies. Only know this world. This world, not ours.
It keens a tiny song, and the scent of failure and loss hangs heavy around it. Well, now I'm starting to really feel bad for these Sticka. They sound like they have a tragic story. Oh yeah, I'd have to stream eating the boat, obviously. In the IRL category. Alright. I'd like to ask other questions. Wait, can you tell me more about this? There was one I forgot to ask. I found a dead Sticka snare here. Can you tell me anything about that? I just gained some XP.
Nell tunnel. Broodmate weakened. Could not feed self. Could not dig eggs. Feed eggs. Digs tunnel to collapse on self. Not want burden stick a family.
Oh, he committed suicide. Holy shit. The great head on the creature shakes ponderously.
Barely strong enough to collapse tunnel. Failed in life. Too weak, perhaps.
Yeah. Well, that sucks. I hate when I'm too weak to dig proper tunnels and I have to kill myself because of it. That's a rough life. Alright, some Price is Right losing horn right there. That Stickus is just going ham on that wall. Yeah, he's going nuts. He's going nuts. Alright, I'd like to ask other questions. Can we talk about Pelii again?
Fish head person. Different grub. Shines strangely in Stickus' eyes. Smell bad in mind. Much like other humans.
Its hand tears a chunk from the wall. Oh, I could lie to him and say I think you can trust her, or I can tell him the truth about getting the eggs. Holy shit. Let's hold off on that. I'd like to ask more questions. We'll come back to that option. Can you tell me about this place again?
Good tunnel rock. Many hidden paths. Place to store eggs. Strong electricity when we dig. Good for eating.
You dig under the city, right? Can you take me someplace?
Maybe take.
The Stickus mutters, though its scent indicates reluctance and caution.
Must pay 10 shins.
Can you take me to the place where your eggs hatch? Yeah, that's gonna go over well. What do Sticka use shins for?
Human sell Numenera. Call self Mekela. Trade shins and other Numenera to Sticka. Dicka trade shins for Numenera good to dig. Melt into walls and tunnels, make stronger. That's why shins.
Alright, he's got a fair point there. I don't think I'm ready to go to the Changing Gods Sanctuary just yet, so I'm not going to ask that. I'm definitely not going to ask him to take him to the place where the eggs hatch. That's going to piss him off, probably. Let me ask you some more questions instead. I've come to ask you to stop digging underneath the city. Hold on, actually, let me save this shit, and then keep talking to him. What is Numenera in this context, Mr. Scotty Mac? Numenera are the leftover artifacts and devices of the past civilization that had incredibly high technology, so much so that the people of this era do not understand it, or know what it was for, or how to reproduce it. But they can salvage some of these pieces of technology and find their own new uses for them. So that's what Numenera are bits of the past, the previous world's technology. Human who speaks
Sticker.
Chukek mutters.
Chukek will speak.
I've come to ask you to stop digging underneath the city.
Why? Where we go, give reason to stop.
You can move deeper beneath the city.
Have been. Rock not good. Soft. Not efficient. Electric not strong.
It leans back.
What else?
Promising the regular tribute of power sources will probably really piss off the council. Hold on a second. Let's back this up. I'm gonna say this. I'm gonna tell him the truth about Pelii and see if that inclines him to trust me and like me more. She asked me to retrieve your eggs. Indigo raised a tiny amount. A heavy stone crumbles to dust in Chukek's fist.
Yes! Knowledge!
A heavy feeling, like lightning about to strike on a hot summer day, settles around you.
Not trust! Fish head grub destroys Dicka for no crime but feeding!
So maybe now that I told him that...
Say before. No! Where do we go?
Alright. Well, I can use the persuasion option. Number 3 does sound like a threat. Let's try number 2. They're not gonna give a shit about this, but let's try number 2 just to see what happens. The humans above are suffering.
When humans dig, they care for us. No. Why we care for them?
Alright, we're gonna try the persuasion here. No, blinking ninja, it's not necessary to play Planescape Torment to understand this game. The two have basically nothing to do with each other. They're not set in the same setting. They don't involve the same characters. They are not the same story. This is a spiritual successor to Planescape Torment, meaning it's designed with similar themes and similar tone and similar design philosophy and gameplay elements, but it's not actually directly, it's not a sequel to Planescape Torment. I'm gonna try the persuasion. Do you want your people to have a future? Do you want war with the humans above? They will collapse your tunnels. They will destroy you. Or maybe I should do the power sources thing. Now, let's try this and see what happens. Oh man, the chance is terrible. I get some from that. I get some from that. I get some from that. The base difficulty is 0. The base difficulty to this is a 0% chance of doing it. Now, I could go nuts with effort and get it all the way up to an 80%, but I'm going to be spending a lot of points from my... I'm going to spend 1. I love the Planescape setting too, Mr. Scotty Mac. I love it. Planescape Torment is my favorite game of all time. It is my favorite game of all time. That's why I was so excited for this game. But they're not actually related to each other narratively or setting-wise in any way. Let's try this. I'm gonna save scum this. Save scumming. It considers your words for a short time and then looms tall.
No, this home can stop humans if need. Maybe humans move instead. They build on food. They surprised it eaten. We stay.
We're surprised their food, it's built on top of food. Well, we didn't know people were going to be eating the rock. Well, actually, they don't technically eat the rock. They use the rock for friction. They eat the electricity, which is pretty interesting. We'll discuss it later. Farewell. All right, hold on. Hold on a second. Let's try this again. Yeah, Planescape Torment's the best game I've ever played, too. Ankaravada, Flame Tongue. He is more reason- Well, that's because I can speak his language, so he's like... He's, you know, pretty intrigued by talking to me, I think. I don't want to use that much effort, though. Damn it. Am I gonna save scum this? Am I save scumming it? I think I'm save scumming it. Fuck it. I'll use 2 effort. Got it. It considers your words for a time, and the scents that surround it vary from the frightening to the mundane. At last, the smell of synth and strong glass waft past your nose, and Chekect says,
"Human give good reason. Yes, sticker comply."
So I resolve this without stealing the eggs. I think I just avoided another fight. Scratches the wall and drums a pattern there.
Stick a move deeper. Burrow to lesser rock. Starve for human's sake. Not fight with humans is better.
Well, that makes me feel bad. Now they're going to be starving. Ten to One says that you'd continually reload the 60% if you weren't streaming. Mr. Scotty Mac, if I wasn't streaming, I would continually load the 40%. Although, I kind of am not happy with the way this went down. I don't think so. I think I'm going to go piss off Pelii. I'm reloading one more time. I'm not even going to do the persuasion. I'm not even going to do it. I'm going to do the power sources thing and see how that plays out. By the way, if you're watching right now, stick around because in about 20 minutes, 20 to 25 minutes from now, I'm going to be giving away a copy of this game. So don't go anywhere. Yeah, endangered their entire race for the sake of the fish lady. I know, right? I felt bad about it. It's not cool. Alright, let's try again. Move beneath the city. Humans are suffering. I can promise a regular tribute of power sources for your people from the city. Stickus leans forward, interested, and the scent of sparks rises.
Might they not offer before? This good. What else?
Wait a minute, what do you mean, what else? There is no else. Never mind, let me ask other questions. That's it for now, farewell. Let's go talk to Pelii and see if you've sufficiently bribed a follow. Yeah, I'm gonna talk to her and see what she has to say now.
I hope you have news for me.
No, I can't talk to her about this at all now. So, looks like I have to do the persuasion. But maybe now they won't starve if I persuade him and they're gonna get the power sources from the... I'm not sure. Let's try this again. Oh, look! The percentage is different! Look! That's cool. Because I offered him the power sources thing, it gives me a plus 15% on this check. Oh, that's cool. It's easier to persuade him now. Yeah. I see that. So I got a 55%. I can go up to 75 with just 1 point. Let's do it. Considers your words for a time, and the scents that surround it vary from the frightening to the mundane. At last, the smell of synth and strong glass waft past your nose, and Chekek says,
"Human give good reason. Yes, Sticker comply." Making a note.
He still says they're gonna starve for human's sake, but I offered them... Well, I can feel good about myself knowing that hopefully they'll at least get some tribute of power sources and they won't starve as much. I managed to negotiate an agreement with the Sticker on my own. Pelii will want to hear the details. The giant Sticker huffs unhappily.
Must send other grub away! Pelii, fish head grub! Tell her we make deal and make her go away.
All right, I'll make her go away.
I hope you have news for me.
I have news about the sticker.
Good news, I trust?
I've handled the negotiations with the sticker.
She lifts one foot to begin pacing, to start considering her options, and she stops. She slowly turns towards you, each eye rotating separately. She lowers her foot and turns to face you squarely and bites off each word.
What did you do?
I convinced Chikect that digging deeper would be a benefit to both the sticker and the humans. There's no need to steal their eggs.
You left their eggs with them? How will we reinforce their exile without that leverage?
She smooths her crest and blinks her eyes slowly.
Fine! We can work with this for now! We have time to engineer another solution!
No! Motherfucker. Something new. Ooh, we just gained a bunch of XP. She stops, a thought striking her.
Did you promise them anything else?
I told them that the city would send them a gift of electrical Numenera from time to time.
She presses a slightly trembling hand to her head. She's face-palming. She's not happy.
I wish you hadn't done that, but perhaps it was the only way to achieve optimal results.
She considers.
Very well. You have achieved your objective. Here is your payment.
150 shins in the house.
Our business here is finished. Good day.
Feeling it. It's fucking rude. She expected him to just leave because she asked. Well, no. She wanted me to go steal their eggs so that they could be like, lol, we have your eggs. Get to stepping or we're going to kill your eggs or whatever. Completed. Shaky foundations. I negotiated a peaceful settlement with the sticker. They have agreed to stop digging near the surface, which means that the homes and public buildings of Sega's Cliffs are safe. Pelii was displeased that I didn't steal the creature's eggs, as she wanted to have leverage over them, but she couldn't argue with the results. And I get another advancement. Yeah, she's pretty monstrous. Alright, do I want to increase stat pools, effort, or ability or skill? Let's say I want ability or skill. What abilities do I have? Oh, I can improve infused weapon. Or I can get any one of these skills. Or I can have two more points in my stat pools. Let's get a skill. Like, I'm gonna get Anamnesis, because I know I'm gonna end up using that a lot throughout the game. But maybe I should get one of these lures, though. Or Quick Fingers, I'm gonna use that a lot. Maybe I should make Perception level 2. Or Persuasion or Deception level 2. Really hard to decide. Really hard to decide. I think they're all going to come into play some of the time, Comet Pants, the lures. I mean, I'd like to have them, but I can't have every skill, so... You know what? I'm going to max out Perception right now, because I don't want to accidentally miss something that you could see with Perception, because I don't have high enough. So I'm maxing out Perception first. I'm not sure about that comment, if putting points into Anamnesis makes it happen more often or not. I don't really know quite how all this works.
Did I learn that? Or remember
I just feel like having more Perception though, so I'm gonna have it. Next advancement, I'll probably put some more points into intellect. Alright, Tiber's going up one too. Oh, let's get some edge for him as well. This takes might. This takes might. Let's get him a point of might edge. Oh, I can't. He's already got edge and effort. He's the only thing I can do is increase his stat pools. Alright. Let's get him some might.
I've learned a thing or two.
Oh, he's reached tier 2. Issue challenge. Cost intellect. All enemies in range who fail to resist being compelled, which makes them attack you, and dazed. Well, that's pretty great. And he can have skill with defense, or resourceful. More ciphers, or better defenses. I think we'll take defenses. Perception is what helped you see how crappy Pelly I was. Yeah, exactly. Because it says right here, under perception, that it unlocks conversation options. So I figure if I have the max rank of it, then I won't miss out on any conversation options from perception ever. Alright, so he's up to tier 2. He has 30 health now. 30. Oh, that's still not as much as Alagarin, but it's pretty good. And the quest is done. Now let's talk to our buddy Chekect again and see what he has to say now.
Egg friend!
Chekect whistles. The smell of dust and closed air surrounds it. The creature is clearly glad to see you.
Stick a dig deep, like promise. Rock not as good there.
The scent of a pocket of trapped gas arises, the equivalent of a shrug.
But Chekect promise. Sticka move. Human want travel?
Can you tell me more about the Sticka? I don't think... Yeah, that's the same questions as before. Alright, so now I can have him take me to the place I need to go, I think. Can you take me someplace under the city? The Stickus bows, almost scuttling, and the warm smell of cooking rock rises from its back.
And to Sticka! Yes! No pay for you! Free!
If you've moved your people deeper underground, can you take me to your old lair? No, let's not do that right now. Let's go to the Sanctuary of the Changing God. I have heard that the Changing God has a sanctuary underneath the city. Can you take me there? It bows.
Yes, for Sticka friend, yes. Can take to egg tunnel, then walk to place, yes.
Nice, we're making some progress here. So far we've handled everything in the game up to this point without having to fight anyone. I know that if you come in here to take the eggs, you've got to fight all the Sticka. I think. You might be able to do it stealthy somehow, but I don't think so. I think you gotta fight them all. New area! Emerging from the freshly dug tunnel, you find yourself in a small chamber with veins of refined metal glimmering along the ground and walls. Chekect turns to face you.
Place beyond was egg rooms, hatching chambers.
Its claws work up and down slowly.
Future Sticka moved far away. Sanctuary on other side of Knot Nest.
So now we're in the Sticka tunnels where we would have had to come. I don't know if it's possible to do the entire game without fighting at all, but I suspect you can avoid most fights. I negotiated a settlement between the Sticca and Sagus Cliffs. Chekek might be willing to take me to the Stitcher Lair now if I asked. Well, he just did that, so that's good. So here we are in the Sticca Lair. This is where I was supposed to use the disco ball thing. But I don't know that I necessarily need to at this point. In before pacifist run. What is this thing? Warm sinews of light lace the walls, spiraling into the base of a hollow statue. It gleams in the same color as the glowing strands. Faint scratches along the base, about the size of a Sticca's claw, suggest they hit the statue while tunneling and could not extract it. Round tubes with apertures of varying sizes connect to a central drum. A soft breeze from the newly dug barrow behind you hums over the openings. The gnarled metallic veins running through the rocky walls deaden the noise from the device. It is unlikely to be heard outside this room. Just stick with it. Thanks, Nox. Thanks for that. Strike the drum at the center of the statue, blow into one of the apertures, reach inside the nearest opening. Oh, I got stuff in there. Just inside the tube, you feel a piece of loose material. It pulls free with a light tug. Whatever technology this statue represents has been worn away by digging and time, but the fragments may still be useful to you. I got a couple of elutriated forests and some shins. The cylindrical drum and snaking tubes that make up this statue lie idle and silent. Well, let's try blowing into an aperture, because why not? Your stomach flips as a wave of vibrating air buffets you for a fraction of a second. Golden light flows up from the seams into the statue, forming a looping pattern in the center of the drum. As the rumbling continues, energy coruscates along the veins in the rock running into the device. After a moment, the sound gutters and dies away, but wispy tracings of the pattern continue to glow on the surface. It is approximately the size of a human hand, though the shape is more like a dozen tentacles. It does feel like something's going to attack you down here. I place my hand on the light tracings. Gained XP. The same sound you heard before rattles your gut. It sputters, but remains on, the acoustics having deteriorated over the millennia. Though the sound is intermittent, there's something fascinating about it that forces you to pay attention. You easily tear your focus away, but the effect might be stronger if the statue was fully intact, especially on a creature with non-human psychology. Tiber chuckles. That thing reminds me of a lass I once saw playing a flute in Ion. Had a pack of gents stumbling after her, downright captivated. Might have been her music. Might have been that she didn't have a single stitch on. Still, I remember her smile the most. So what is this thing for? Some sort of hypnotic... The soft hypnotic vibrations continue to resonate from the statue. It's too subtle to be felt from more than a few meters away. Before the statue was damaged, the sounds were probably audible over a wider area. Smooth gray tendrils snake in and out of the rock along this wall, eventually growing out to cover the nearby doorway. Though metallic in texture, the material has grown like a vine or fungus. The individual strands are hard, but warm to the touch. An inky black tendril, with sparks starting from its tip, extends from the blossoming, tightly bound creepers. You might be able to pull it free from the vine. That sounds dangerous. I can attempt to wrench the tendril off the vine, or I can try to find the grain of the vine and pull against it. Well, let's see. If we do this one, He's got a 65% chance. If we do this one... Alright, we're gonna go with the 65. With, our buddy here. And hope for the best. Got it. Success. Running a finger along the tendril, you feel a slight striation that indicates the grain of the vine. You slip a hand around it and pull directly against the weft. It comes cleanly free. The other strands loosen and separate as you move the fragment by them, then wind back together. We got a mycometal vine fragment. This is a fragment of the organic metal vine you found growing in the Stickus lair. It shows some unusual magnetic properties. It's an oddity worth a bunch of money. Cool. I'll take it. I will take it. Without the fragment that repelled the others, the vine has wound itself back together. And this? It's acting like this. Oh, maybe that's to open the door here, and the door is already open. So, yeah, okay. A lot going on in here. Sings harmony with the statue vibrations. Wonderful. Alright, I think it's about time to end an episode. If you're watching the stream, don't go anywhere, because not only am I not done playing, I'm about to give away a game. This game, in fact. If you're watching on YouTube, though, that's going to do it for this episode. So thank you for watching. This has been Josiah Plays Torment, Tides of Numenera.